Hey guys, this is Alachia, and this is my review for the teaser for Pacific Rim 2 Uprising. Now, I did not realize that this weekend was San Diego Comic-Con. I'm not really with it, with the trades. And so I was like, oh shit, that's this weekend. Oh, it's going to be a hell of a busy weekend. Plus, I'm going to go see Valerian tonight, and then maybe even Dunkirk tonight if I'm feeling energetic. Most likely tomorrow, though. But it's going to be a pretty busy weekend with a lot of the trailers dropping and a lot of them being things that I want to discuss. Like this one. And I don't think that there's actually a Pacific Rim panel. I think that Universal just sort of dropped this trailer. So my initial gut reaction to the teaser is giggity. I loved Pacific Rim, which I'll talk about in a bit after I go over the teaser trailer. And so when they kind of shelved Pacific Rim 2 for a while, and then Guillermo del Toro, who did the original, kind of dropped out of directing it. I felt like, oh, they're not even going to pursue that. It wasn't like a super successful franchise in terms of box office numbers, but it definitely had a cult following. People like me who love mechs, just, it was the most beautiful movie you could have possibly have made. And it was one of those films that after I'd finished watching, I really think that people who clap in movies are ridiculous. But after the movie ended, I was just like, brilliant. You know, I didn't clap, but I wanted to. So anyhow, that they're actually going to be doing it too, that it actually got greenlit, moving forward, it's happening, teaser has dropped. So exciting. And I saw a lot of people in the comments who were just like, what the hell? Why is GLaDOS in this trailer? And I was like, did you guys not watch the first movie? The voice of GLaDOS is in the first movie as well. Now, the thing is that this is just a simple trailer that is more like a viral video. You know how movies will often release viral videos to go in conjunction with their trailers, which are a little bit more meta. And I think this is one of them. And this is a recruitment type video that is trying to get young people to join the Jaeger movement. So it has a very stylized, polished look to it, almost like, you know, a Mac commercial or an iPhone commercial. And then you have John Boyega at the end. And it's very exciting to see him in this role because I do feel like, you know, he has not been able to showcase what he can do. I feel like his role in Star Wars was greatly diminished. And at first I thought it was just him. Maybe he was a bad actor. But then I realized it's not. It was just the role he was given, the script he was given, and the limitations of that particular character. And I think that we'll see later in August, Detroit, I think we're going to see him showcase more of his acting chops. I keep hearing about Attack the Block, but I haven't gotten a chance to see it yet. But from what I can tell, he looks like a very good dramatic actor who can really carry different scopes and different character roles. So I'm very excited to see him in this as a main character. Charlie Hunnam, I wasn't like a huge fan of him from the original. He was just a character. Again, it's not really about the humans in this case. It's about the technology that is presented in this universe along with the amazing kaiju monsters. And so looking at it, being so polished, so stylized, definitely one of those viral marketing videos that is all about kind of like a Starship Troopers recruitment video. So I kind of, although I was like super, super excited, I was like, yes, yes, bring me Pacific Rim 2. I'm worried. Like Alachia always brings her, you know, cynicism bucket that she's got to draw from all the time. And so I am a little worried about this particular look. I'm hoping that that's just the viral video and that the actual, when we actually see the full-on trailer, that will return to more of the clunky style of the original Jaegers. I think that with Pacific Rim, the original, what was so great about the way they portrayed the mechs is the scope and scale. And you don't want to have this overly CG version of the mechs because then it just feels like an anime, right? And one of the things that made Pacific Rim so amazing to watch on the big screen is watching those Jaegers try to move, work against gravity, and just the hydraulic systems and the sheer force and power that you could see through every bit of action. It wasn't this fluid CGI movement. It really felt like everything was compartmentalized, that it was a drudge, that it was all full of, like, you know, mechanical, you know, all these mechanisms going into place to make this mech work. And that is what was so brilliant, I think, about Pacific Rim. Not a lot of people are just going like, oh, hello, you know how stupid that stupid neural rift drifting shit was? And I'm like, I'm sorry, I can't hear you over the amazing fucking, like, Jaeger kaiju battles. I can't hear you. Just, yes, I know there are plot holes in their first movie. I mean, I could have given two shits about the acting and the script. But I did like the world building. And again, the mechs were perfect, absolutely perfect. So I do not want to see that diminish in Pacific Rim 2. I'm really hoping that we're not getting kind of a move towards Transformers. Like, what I would hate is like, okay, yeah, now guys, we're going to do Pacific Rim 2, but this time we're going to have merchandisable toys. Oh God, that would just be awful, freaking awful. So I think we're just going to have to wait and see until the actual trailer drops. I think this is just one of those viral videos, and that's giving us a sense of what's coming, and that, you know, they are changing up things where I don't think we're going to have the drifting where you're going to need two people to pilot the Jaegers. I think they probably move the technology forward so that you don't have that little caveat in the plot that makes people need to co-pilot. And we can just concentrate on really kick-ass Jaegers versus, you know, that interdimensional portal that probably needs to be closed up so the kaiju can't keep coming out and destroying our world. All right, so let me know what you guys thought of the Pacific Rim 2 teaser trailer. And if you have my concern, if you share my concerns about the over-stylized iPhone version of the Jaegers, and if you actually enjoyed the first one. I mean, the first one was... it was a work of art. I loved it so much. So it is a shame that Guillermo del Toro, God, I can never say his name like fluidly, isn't going to be directing this. He still has some production, I think, part of it. I think he's executive producer. I'm not quite sure. But it's a little bit more hands-off. And so it'll be interesting to see if they do this weird soft reboot and try to make it more Power Rangers, which, yeah, God. I mean, I love Power Rangers. I mean, I don't love Power Rangers, but I liked what they did with Power Rangers, but that's a very specific, you know, stylization, and Pacific Rim has its own, and I want it to retain that amazing quality that it had in the first one. You know, I want to see boats being lifted and smashed into kaiju's faces. I want to see massive destruction. I want to see that mechanism still in play where it looks like it's drudged to move these things and they're moving through the water and banging on the streets and, you know, the entire, like, earth is just shaking. That needs to stay there. I do not want to see this amazing fluid movement, very stylized CGI. Nah, keep it simple, keep it really grounded, make it have that impact and keep that scale, right? Keep that scale so that you're in awe. Like, that's, you watch Pacific Rim and as soon as you're introduced to the Jaegers, you're just like, oh, I'm not worthy. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching. And if you'd like to see more, you can click right here or right here to watch more now. Until next time, see you on the flip side.